Okay, now we get to review the black sheep of the Halloween franchise. It seems that a lot of horror series at one point get to so many sequels that the studios have no choice to do something different from a tired formula. If you look at Friday the 13th, A New Beginning, we discover that Jason actually isn't the killer, and that a paramedic has simply used the Jason story to go on a killing spree. Then there's Wes Craven's New Nightmare, in which Freddy, as more of an evil entity, decides to spring out of films and into the real world to off his creators. However, neither one of these films truly ignored the installments that came before them. They still carry over certain plot elements, so you could still technically include them in their respective timelines. The same doesn't hold true for the third Halloween film. You're probably thinking, really? They only did two Halloween films before alternating the formula? There have been a lot of people who've covered this movie already, so most of you probably know that it's irrelevant to the rest of the series. But it is still a part of the Halloween franchise, and since we're covering them, I might as well do this one as well. For those who aren't familiar with it, here's a little background. John Carpenter, the creator of the series, wasn't a rerun sort of guy. He saw the Halloween franchise as an anthology series, where each installment told a different story and used completely different characters. The series would have been linked only in that each film took place on Halloween. Halloween 2 definitely ended the Michael Myers saga in his eyes, so Carpenter opted to take the series in another direction. Hence, Season of the Witch. In my earlier reviews, I might have given you the impression that I don't like this one. Quite the contrary, as I find it quite an amusing little horror film on its own merits. But from what I understand, the movie was a big box office flop. After all, the film does call itself Halloween 3, and so from an audience standpoint, fans expected to see Michael Myers. Look at any other horror franchise. No matter how many times you kill someone, fans go to a sequel to see their favorite characters come back. They should have probably just called it Season of the Witch, as opposed to including it in the Halloween series. After all, if Carpenter really wanted to get away from the Michael Myers storyline, he should have probably just exited the series to begin with. Anyway, moving on to Halloween 3, Season of That Dude from RoboCop.
Dick, you're fired!
Thank you.
Nice shooting, son.
Season of the Witch, sorry. It's a strange little movie, dealing with robots, Stonehenge, Celtic rituals, and witchcraft. The main character is Dr. Dan Challis, a stereotypical alcoholic who people like to point out actually cheats on his wife. Now, I've always wanted to dispute this because from the way they act, I almost want to say he's divorced, just because him and his wife seem to have a distant relationship.
So, how you been?
Halloween, Halloween, Halloween.
I gotta call in.
Drinking and doctoring, great combination.
However, there are hints that the former is true.
Convincing, aren't they? Loyal and obedient, unlike most human beings.
This is gonna cost you some serious dinners when you get back.
I'm always ready for dinner with you.
If anything, he's definitely a womanizer, so I wouldn't really put it past him. That's one of the film's faults, is that he's not really a likable character. It's kind of hard to root for him because he lacks that pure quality that Jamie Lee Curtis had in the past films. From the opening titles, the film has a really unsettling atmosphere. It's not quite as effective as the opening titles for Halloween 2. The first image we see is a virtual pumpkin, comprised of computer graphics on a monitor. I'm not sure what this has to do with the rest of the movie, but just listen to the music. It's creepy. It should also be noted that this film really isn't even in the same category as the first two films. It's not even really a slasher, but rather pays homage to some of the sci-fi horror films of the 50s. It starts off with an old man running from some guys in suits. The only thing he has on him is a pretty chintzy Halloween mask, which is actually a key story element. He stops at a gas station where the attendant takes him to the hospital to get looked at. If you pay close attention, you'll also notice that on the TV, they're reporting about the sudden disappearance of one of the Stonehenge slabs, which actually comes into play at the end of the movie. At the hospital, the old man goes into shock when he sees this mask commercial. This commercial will seriously haunt you throughout the film. It plays during almost every scene. I swear, it will have you pulling your hair out. It's a major factor in what ends up happening, but still, did they need to play it so damn much? The song is actually a countdown to the film's final act, so in that regard, it works as a dramatic tool. But come on, they could have come up with something that's not as mind-numbingly annoying. Actually, the whole film is about time. The movie counts down the days until October 31st. The repeating commercial tells us how many days are left until Halloween, and toward the end of the film, Dr. Challis has a very limited amount of time to stop whatever's going to happen. So there's a little suspense, but it still works in a different way than in the past two films. So getting back on track, the old man gets brutally killed in his hospital bed, and it turns out that he's the father of Ellie Grimbridge. She teams up with Dr. Chalice as they go through her father's records and discovers what kind of trouble he's in. They use his records to find the town where all these strange Halloween masks are being manufactured. As they drive through this town, notice how surreal everything is. All the bystanders notice them driving through. This is where the film gets even stranger. This is the most violent film in the history of the Halloween franchise. We find out that these masks kill people. I mean, not just kills them, mutilates them. As in tearing open their face, allowing for bugs and all kinds of creepy crawly crap to come out. We find out that it's all part of Connell Cochran's plan to sacrifice all the kids of the world. His diabolical TV commercial will activate the Halloween masks at 9 o'clock p.m. on Halloween, incinerating anyone who watches. It all goes back to ancient Celtic rituals. We find out that somehow Cochran stole the Stonehenge slab and used its powers for creating the masks. It's twisted, surreal, and pretty bloody. My favorite scene is where Cochran's drones kill off this belligerent alcoholic. They don't just decapitate him, as that usually involves some kind of weapon. They literally twist off his head with their bare hands. The ending is the one thing I never liked. When he rescues Ellie, we find out that they turned her into a robot as well. It's disturbing because if you notice, she doesn't say one word during their daring escape from the factory. On top of that, no matter how many times Chalice dismembers her, she keeps coming back like a zombie. Halloween 3 is a hard one to explain, but an easy one to talk about. But again, it isn't what you generally think of when you think Halloween. Yeah, you think of the guy in the white Bill Shatner mask. In that regards, it gets a lot of flack from diehard Michael Myers enthusiasts, but its biggest crime is that it's called Halloween 3. If you see it for what it is, a gratifying horror experience, moderately entertaining, with its own brand of scares, and some pretty gruesome ones at that.
It's 4 days of Halloween, Halloween, Halloween. It's 4 days of Halloween, Silver Shamrock. It's 4 days of Halloween, Halloween, Halloween. It's 4 days of Halloween, Silver Shamrock.
Sets for the horathon, and remember the big giveaway at 9. Don't miss it, and don't forget to wear your masks. The clock is ticking. It's almost time.
Happy, happy Halloween, Halloween, Halloween. Happy, happy Halloween, Silver Shamrock. Happy, happy Halloween, Halloween, Halloween. Happy, happy Halloween, Silver Shamrock.
Hurry home for the big giveaway. It's almost time. Hurry home.
Stop it! Stop it! Stop it! Stop it! Stop it! Stop it!